Hey guys, welcome to a very long overdue video. On the Facebook forum, I had said I was going to get this up in a couple weeks after I had printed the parts, but with printing mishaps and spring break and fairly heavy course load at school, it's kind of pushed everything off. So I finally have a break in my schedule where I can do some filming and get this video out to you. So the main purpose for this video is backlash. If you remember from my last video of the CNC, I had some problems with some backlash in the lead screws. And so in the comments below, several people have said they had the same problem, and a couple others have suggested some solutions to that. So one of them actually recommended these backlash lead screws, which I don't know how well you can see that. This is just on a little section cutoff that I had. So this is the beginning of what I came up with. This washer would go over the, well, it could go for the Y-axis or the X-axis, but this is the anti-backlash lead screw. So there is absolutely no backlash in there, which is beautiful. It definitely runs a little rougher, which is to be expected, more friction. And I've heard they wear out quicker. I assume that's true. Sounds pretty valid. But why don't we hop in the computer and I'll show you what my final design I came up with. Alright, so what we have here is for the spindle, the X-axis carriage. So I just joined it to this little washer that attaches on the sides. There's not much of a better name for it than that, but I also made this for the Y-axis, and so you can see I added them, and what I had to do is I had to widen the hole through here. You can see these screw cutouts are chopped off halfway, but I also added a hole right here in the side, so you can put a screw through there, and you can also put one through there. And I made a holes here too, so you can screw it to the front just like normal, and you can still screw the lead screw nut into the thing a little bit. So the spindle one is a little narrower, and I had to notch it at least here because that screw head is gonna stick out, especially with the thickness of this. I didn't wanna make it super, super thin. So I ended up notching it, and the screw head, I may countersink this, but when I put the screw in there, it just barely rubs on that. But once I ran this back and forth a couple of times over the screw head, it kind of notched itself out in the plastic, and I don't think I'm gonna have any problems with it. I haven't had any problems yet. I just milled some half inch plywood with it and it did fine. So that's basically all that I did to it. So that's going to help the backlash, obviously, with the Y-axis and then with the X-axis as well. I'm not going to put it on the Z because there's always a constant downforce, and there's not much of a need for that as of this moment. I haven't changed out these connectors yet with the solid ones, which I do have a part for. I printed them. I just have not attached them. I saw Nikodem had attached something similar to this in his video where he did the aluminum. So this is what I've come up with as a solution. I think the best way to test this would be to mill a circle, as that would test out the X and Y axes and their backlash in each. So let's give it a try. Here's some pieces from a previous test I did, cutting out our tractor pull sled, which is another project I'd want to put up. But you can see there's some little lines there. It's hardly noticeable. I did very well, actually, on these contours. This is, I think, three different layer depths. You can just barely see a lip on there. Not sure how well you can see that, but I'm pretty happy with what it's done so far. So now we're going to cut out a circle and see how well it does.
Hey, look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Look at how beautiful that is. No, that's not so beautiful, but there are barely any lines in that. That is like perfect. I am very impressed. Now it's time to see if this thing is dimensionally consistent. So I designed it in the computer, this outer circle, to be 4 inches. And since this won't reach, I'll do my best here to lock it on. But I'm getting that. That's pretty darn close to 4 inches. And for those of you across the pond, there's your millimeters. This inner circle is supposed to be 2 inches. How accurate that measurement is, I don't know. Not really using the right tool. But that's close to 2 inches, a little bit under, obviously. Yeah, I can't get a terribly great measurement, but that's pretty doggone close, so I'm pretty happy with those results.